Welcome everyone to our YouTube series, Test Prep Made Easy. So in this particular series, we are going to post regularly questions on our YouTube channel. The questions may pertain to CAT preparation, may be pertaining to GMAT preparation, as well as of various topics which are tested in these particular exams. For example, Quants, LRDI, English, and various areas which are tested. And each day, we will handle certain number of questions and their video solutions. The best approach is to these questions in these videos. So have a happy preparation ahead and enjoy the video. Thank you.
Okay, so this is the LR set that we are going to discuss in this video. Hopefully you have already tried it from the thumbnail itself. If you haven't, you can pause the video at this point. We recommend you to try it once before you watch the solution. And if you just want to enjoy the solution, you're welcome to do the same thing. Just go ahead and watch the solution, which will be starting now. This type of LR set can appear in any exam where LR is a section of testing. It's not a very tough set as such, but definitely an interesting one. If you are familiar with few basic processes related to binary logic and conditionalities, these will be the two things that will be tested in the set. Then you can definitely manage to solve the set in less than 6 minutes. So in roughly 5 to 6 minutes for this particular set should be enough. But enough with the strategic discussion related to the set. Let us really get into solving the set now. But before I do that, let me point out a few important things in the set. Okay, so the first thing, if you notice this part of the premise, the tattlers always spoke the truth. The leechers always lied. And then there's another category, the confounders randomly lied or spoke the truth. So this is the typical type of idea that is prevailed in binary logic. Now, this name has been changed, right? So typically, I would call these three types as truth teller, liar, and this one I say alternator. I have delved into variations of alternators in our lessons and all. I don't want to go that much deep in this particular video. But yeah, since the name have been changed, so what I typically do is in my rough work, I'll always take a note of this. So I'll just write it in short. So I know that this tattlers thing that we have, so let me write this completely only here, are the truth teller. So truth teller, I typically always indicate as TT. So that's a habit for myself. You can just simply use a T, I guess that should also work. Then you have those leechers and they are the liars. So liars, I always indicate by a L. So I'll just use an L for leechers. And for the confounders, these are the alternators. So I just use A for alternators. I mean, this is typically this TT, L, and this A are the symbols that I use whenever I solve a binary logic set. So if you want to use the same symbols, you can do that. So whenever I'll collect anything or take cases or analyze something, I use the TT, L, and the A. The other thing, now when it comes to a good set on binary logic, what you have to understand is it will not be a single dimensional only binary logic based set, because that will be typically very easy. And mostly when it is in an LRDI set, so there will be multiple questions with it. So there should be two dimension at least of thinking. So in most of the binary logic kind of set that you will experience throughout your preparation, you will find many of them have an arrangement with it that you also have to solve, or maybe a number distribution kind of thing that you need to do. In this particular set, what has happened is the binary logic idea has been combined with a conditionality idea. So what I mean by that is, so let me just take these things off before I explain. And let me draw your attention to the statements that each of the three people out here has made. So if you look at this part, so it says, if we are all of the same group, then we are all leechers, right? So it's like, if this happens, then something like this has to happen. Each of the statements, same with B, same with C. So these are known as conditionality. So depending on a condition, something will be true or not true. So this is a if-then type. So I will discuss a little bit on it, not too much in details, but just a basic idea. It's very easy to understand. Just assume a statement. So I'm just writing a statement out here. If X, then Y, something like this. So this is the statement. Now, the conclusion, the basic conclusion, just think about basic conclusion from this question's point of view. The basic conclusion is if X happens, then Y has to happen, right? So in this case, what I mean is X is maybe some event. Just for example, this Arvind guy says if we are all of the same group. So this entire we are all of the same group is this X. So I'm just indicating that with variable, whatever you can have there. So the normal conclusion is if X happens, then Y should happen, right? That is what the statement is telling us. The trick is, most of you will be aware of this if you have experienced this type of things. So just bear with me. So if there's a not X, so for example, take the example again of Arvind's statement. So Arvind says, if we are all of the same group, so you don't have to read the rest of it. Just read this X part. So we are all of the same group. If they are not of the same group, then this particular statement has no bearing at all. So what I mean by that is, if they are not of the same group, then it doesn't matter whether they're leechers or not leechers. So Y may happen, may not happen. It really doesn't matter. So in this case, so if not X, then ideally you have nothing to say about Y. So nothing can be said about Y. So that is the thing. Now, since this is the reason I've been explaining this part again, since this is a binary logic based set as well. So as I mentioned earlier, we will try to make the statements true or false. So try to connect these two thinking out here. So in this context, think about one of these three statements. So A, B, C, three of them have made statements, all are if then type of statement. So how can one of these statements be false? You should be considering that. Because true, it can happen in a lot of different ways. X not being true, then Y may be true, may not be true. So a lot of different ways where the truth can happen for a particular statement. But how about the false? How does one of these statements become false? Just consider this. So we know from the first part. So let me highlight this. So if you look at this thing, we know that if X happens, then Y has to happen, right? So if I have something like this, X happens and we have a not Y. So Y does not happen. So something like, if you look at Arvind's statement again, if they are of the same group, but they are not leechers, X has happened, but Y is not happening. So now the statement is false, right? You will understand the significance of this after a while. Initially that I claimed that you can actually solve it in 5 minutes. The better you understand the basics of these kind of binary logic and conditionality, and these mini topics of the LRDI section. So if you are aware of the basic ideas and how they are related, not just that you have mugged it up and didn't understand it. So if you do understand these basic ideas, this type of analysis can be done very, very, very quickly. So let us look a little bit deeper into the actual information. So let us look at Arvind's statement. So Arvind says, if we are all of the same group, then we are leechers. Great. Beria says, if just one of us three belong to a different group, then that person is a leecher. All right. I'm just overviewing the statements now. If each of us belong to a different group, then I am a leecher. Okay, so first time I scan the statements a bit properly. So in this case, what I'm noticing is, look at the, if part, the X part of each of the statement. By the way, the technical name is hypothesis. So just look at the hypothesis of each of these statements. We are all of the same group. Just one of us three belong to a different group. Each of us belong to a different group. What you got to understand that there are three people, right? In the if part of each person, they do not specify the group at that point of time, right? That has been done later on in the then part to some extent. So if you look at the statements in the X part, the hypothesis part, each of the statements are just talking about grouping. Now, if you understand, there are three people out here. So for the three people, the number of ways to group them. So three people, anyhow, you can distribute into groups in one of these three ways, so either a 300 or a 210 or a 111. So basically what I mean by that is 300 is all the three in the same group, 210, two of them in one of the groups, we don't know which one, and one of them separately in another group. Again, doesn't matter which one. And 111, because there are three groups and three people. So 111 is basically all of them in one different group. So everybody in a different group. So if you look at Arvind's, Beria's and Chandan's hypothesis, so let me indicate that that as X only so that you can relate it to this thing. So the X part of A, the X part of B, and the X part of C are these three different groupings that are anyhow possible, right? So what it means is at least one of them, and not actually at least, exactly one of these three things. So each of these hypotheses, only one of them, exactly one of them has to be true, right? You can never have two of these cases simultaneously occurring. I mean, that is very silly, right? I mean, if three of them are in the same group, how are they in different groups? So that is never possible. So exactly one of these three has to be there, right? Has to be correct. Now, if you consider the initial thing that I talked about, the false statement, if you remember, it has to be X followed with a not Y, not a not X followed with something. So statement can be false in only this case, right? So now let us get into these three cases. So these three cases is something I have to figure it. I have to encounter. Otherwise, there is no way I can figure this out. So let us go case by case. So let me just write this as case one, case two, and this being case three or something. So let's deal with case one first. In case one, so all the three of them has to be in the same group, right? So this A, B, C, all should be of the same type, whatever that type is. Now, that is what the case one is. Now, let us look at Arvind's statement as well. So what does Arvind say? Let me first take these things off. Yeah. So Arvind says, if we are all of the same group, then we are all leeches. Now, see, at this point, because this particular hypothesis is true, the X is true, we can actually have the conclusion to be true as well as false. So that is possible. But consider the situation where the, you know, the statement is true or something. So if the statement is true, then what you have to understand is all of these three have to be a liar. Because if you remember, the leecher is basically a liar. So all of them have to be a liar, right? Because all of them are part of the same group. Now, the problem is if Arvind is actually a liar, if all of them are liar, Arvind is a part of that, right? If Arvind is a liar, then how is he making a true statement? So we are assuming that this is a true statement, right? So effectively what we know is this statement cannot be true, right? So whatever Arvind has spoken. So Arvind's statement has to be false. So this statement is definitely false. And to make the statement false, the only way we can make the statement false is X followed by not Y. So they are part of the same group. So X is true, but they are not leeches. So that then only the statement can be false, right? And they cannot be truth teller as well, because anyhow, they're making a false statement. Arvind is making a false statement. So the only thing that is left out is alternator, right? So let me just write an A for this, or you might get confused between this A and this. So I'll just write ALT for alternator for this particular set. So this is case one, and this is very much possible, right? ABC together being alternator. And this will happen when Arvind's statement is false. So let me keep this as a separate note. So this is what I'll technically do in my rough work as well. I'll just make these small boxes and I'll just collect them one after the other. So let me just shift this a little bit because I have to manage the space as well. And then I'll carry on with the case two. Great. So I just reduce the size a bit. And this is happening when Arvind is making a false statement that is also noted by me. So let me just take these things off. And now let us look at the second statement or the Beria statement. So this is when case two is true. That is when we have to look at it. So case two is nothing but 210. So Beria says if just one of us three belong to a different group, great, that is a 210, then that person is a leecher. So what is Beria talking about? So Beria says that the one person who is, you know, different from the other two is a leecher, right? So let us consider that Beria statement is true. So if Beria statement is true, or this entire thing is true, so the one person that is different from the other, so there is one group of two people, let me make this a little bigger, which are of the same type, and then there is this single person who has to be the liar, right? So let me write this explicitly. So this person has to be a liar because that is what Beria is saying, and we are considering that to be true. And because you're considering this to be true, so Beria has to be here because Beria cannot be the liar, right? How does he make a true statement then? So this means one of these two things has to be a false statement. Now, who has who are these two individuals? This is one of them is A, another is C, right? So let us consider any one of them. The thing is, there is a small problem out here. Whichever case you consider, in this case, you see that C becomes the liar. Switch it and A becomes the liar. The problem is with any other person becoming a liar, because try to understand, a liar will always make a false statement, right? And if you remember the initial analysis that I did, only one of these three statements could be false. If then type of statement can be false only when the hypothesis is true and the conclusion is false. So forget about the conclusion, focus on the X. So if we are on to case two, it has to be a 210 case, right? Whatever be the sub case under it, but it has to be a 210 case. Now, the thing is, if let's say in this example that I took, C is the liar. So C's statement has to be false and C is making this statement, right? So if C is making this this third statement, the only way this can be false is that each of them belong to a different group and then C is not a leecher. Only then it can be false, as I initially talked about here, right? So the problem is that it has to be 210 as well as 111, but that is not possible, isn't it? So how can, you know, three people be divided into groups in 210 format as well as 111 format? I mean, they can either be on different groups or they will two of them will be in the same group, right? So effectively, we know that be true, or this statement being true, is not possible. I mean, that is something we know, right? But this this case also has a sub case where the statement made by B has to be false. And let us look at that one now. So if B is false, then by the way, this statement becomes false, right? So that person whomsoever B is talking about is not a liar. So this person is not a liar, whoever is the single one. So it's either a truth teller or an alternator, something like this. So let me just, truth teller or alternator. Now the interesting thing is, here there are two people, right? Now the logic that we used here, so same way we can say that two people cannot be liar, right? If two of the people are liar, their hypothesis has to be true. And we have already realized that same hypothesis can never, two different hypotheses can never be simultaneously true. So this group of two people also cannot be liars. So they are either alternators or truth tellers. So B has to be an alternator, but we cannot just assign B anywhere, because it could be B here and this being the alternator, and we can have AC here, or we can have a B here. And this becomes an alternator, and whoever A, C comes in this way, or C, A comes in this way. So anything is possible out here. I mean, a lot of different things are possible. So let me just minimize this a bit, as I did for the previous one, and then I'll explain whatever I wrote down. Okay, so what I've just done is, B is definitely an alternator. If you remember, that is something we have understood in the previous case. while analyzing this case. The only thing we cannot comment anything about is A and C. Yes, we can say one thing that in this particular case, A and C both simultaneously cannot be alternator, because that will give us this case basically, all three of them together, which is also true. Anyhow, but they could be both truth teller. That is possible according to the statement. So this, if both, I mean, both A and C are truth teller and B is the alternator, we are actually in the 210 case only, isn't it? So this is quite possible. But the statement made by B is false, right? So that is what I've just done here. Same thing I've written here also. So statement by A is false in the first case. Let me just take this off and let us look at the third statement. So third statement is by Chandan. It says, if each of us belong to a different group, so this is the 111 case, then I'm a leecher. So if we think about the third case, let me write it in this way. If statement made by C is true, then this is a similar problem that happened in the previous case. So in this case, C will be an alternator. But that means one of A or B has to be a leecher, because don't forget that this is or basically a liar. Please understand that this is a 111 case. That is what we are dealing with. So there has to be one liar, one truth teller, and one alternator in this case, right? So so this statement cannot be true, that much is for sure. And similarly, if statement this statement is false, so this can only be false when he is not a leecher, right? So again, if you take the same thing, I mean, this is a false statement, so has to be an alternator, cannot be a truth teller, because cannot be a liar as well, because he says I'm a liar. So this particular person has to be an alternator again. Same problem, one of A or B has to be a liar. So whether you take the statement to be true or the statement to be false, one of A or B additionally has to be liar. And what did you remember from the previous case analysis? Multiple statement cannot be false in this case, or in this particular premise, because in that case, multiple hypotheses have to be simultaneously true, and the hypothesis, the way it has been presented, it can never be true because they're talking about different grouping, 300, 210, 111. So effectively, what we know is the case three can never be valid. So these are the possibilities that we have. There are two cases which are valid, case one and case two. So depending on the question, we will handle the, you know, answers accordingly. So let's get into the questions. All right. The first question is looking for which of the following is true. Great. Arvind is a tattler. Now, when it says which of the following is true, it means definitely true. Definitely is implicit. You don't have to explicitly mention that. But possibly true is something you have to write explicitly. Arvind is a tattler is not definitely true. That is what we are looking for, because Arvind can be an alternator also. Here also you can see Arvind is an alternator. Both the cases are acceptable. Do not forget that. So that is incorrect. Beria is actually always an alternator. If you look at these two cases, Beria is always an alternator, and confounder is the alternator, right? So option C is the correct answer here. Let's look into the next one. How many among Arvind, Beria, Chandan are leechers? So leechers are the liars. Now, interestingly, whichever case you pick up, there are no liars among this ABC, right? So the number of liars among ABC is definitely zero. Nice question. Let's look into the next one. Okay, so this one asks for which of these two friends are definitely in the same group. Now, this is a problem even before I go into the options, because what you have to understand is if I take this case, then all of them are in the same group, right? So when it says two friends are definitely in the same group, my attention goes to this particular case, because these are sub cases inside it, right? I mean, as I mentioned earlier, A and C cannot be simultaneously alternator, then it will shift to this case. But they can be simultaneously truth teller, right? So only A and C could actually be, I mean, this option doesn't say only A and C, but even if that's it, A and C could be in a separate group or in the same group, or whatever the question is looking for. BA, obviously, yes. BC, obviously, yes. But that is not the question. What is looking for? They're looking for which of these two friends are definitely in the same group. You cannot definitely say about any two specific person because of this particular case, right? It could very well be that C is on a different group than AB. It could be that A is on a different, A is on a different type than B, C, and same ways. But anyhow, so the answer here should be none of these. None of these are definitely in the same group. Depends on the case. So let's look into the next question now. Okay, so this is the if type. So it says if Arvind is a tattler. So Arvind tattler is not possible in case one. So we are picking up case two. So we are picking up something like this. Arvind is a tattler. Then what can we say about Chandan? Now, this is interesting because about Chandan, we still don't have an answer. See, if Arvind would have been an alternator, still we would not have an answer because it is possible that Arvind and Chandan are both alternators, not in this case, but very well possible in this case, right? So what I'm saying is Arvind and Chandan, each of them could be either alternator or truth teller. That is one thing. Second thing is, neither of the person is dependent on what the other person is of type, because case one also exists, right? Where Arvind and Chandan are both alternators. Yeah, of course, in case two, that can never happen. But in case one, it can happen until unless there is any extra information. And Arvind is a tattler is not an information because, as I said, A and C are independent of each other. Arvind being tattler or Chandan, tattler or whatever that is, confunders, C has no effect on it. So C could very well be a tattler or a confunder. But yes, so if you look at the options, so C is the correct answer here. He is not a leecher because anyhow, nobody can be a leecher. Option C is the correct answer here. Let's look into the next one. Okay, so this is the last question. It asks for which of the following is definitely false. Okay, so let's look into the options only. First is Arvind is a tattler. Now, Arvind could be tattler, right? So we're looking for definitely false. So this is possible. So I'll put a check mark wherever it is possible. When it is not possible, that will be our answer. Chandan is a tattler. Now, Chandan is a tattler is also possible. I mean, Chandan could be a truth teller, right? So this is possible. C says they all belong to the same group. Now, this is possible. ABC could be in the same group. That is case one. They all belong to the different groups. Not possible. So answer is option D. Pretty standard set. I wouldn't say very tough. If you understand these basic ideas, this type of set becomes a scoring one in your exam. So I hope you got the ideas that are relevant in this. If you do want to have a specific understanding of these kind of basic ideas in a proper manner, I mean more variations and more ideas that are presented through it, then you can definitely check our capsules. That's it for this particular set. I hope everything was understood. I had fun attempting the set. Not a very tough set to do, but conditionality plus binding logic is my favorite type. I mean that is the part where these kind of analysis becomes a very, very strong concept. But yeah, that's all I had to add regarding the set. Thanks for joining it.
Hopefully you liked the solutions we provided for these questions. And if you did like it, do not forget to like the video and share, subscribe and comment. Do subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon. In that case, you'll get notification as soon as we upload a new video. And if you want to check a bouquet of courses that we provide, so we have a huge variant of courses from customizability to full preparation, you can check our website www.mathoratory.com. I'll leave the link in the description below, and have an enjoyable preparation ahead. Welcome to the Mathoratory family and have a good exam ahead.